God can use you to make a difference in a person's life? A man shared this experience with me some years ago. He was so down, so distraught, so without hope that he thought the only option he had was to end his life. He was driving to the place where he was going to do just that when for some reason he stopped to buy gas. As he was walking to his vehicle, about to get in and drive to the place where his life would end, a man he vaguely knew called out to him. "Hey, what are you doing Tuesday night?" Well, at this stage, I'm not expecting to be doing much." The man invited him to his home for a group Bible study, so our man decided to attend. The rest of the story? He gave his life to Jesus and became active in ministry and a vital part of the church. Because someone reached out to him. I don't know, but I imagine the man who gave the invitation might even have wrestled with doing so. What if he says, "No, I hardly know him, he probably won't come." But there's no doubt God was prompting him to invite that man to his home. God saw what was going on. He knew there wasn't only a life hanging in the balance, but someone's eternal life. And the eternal life of all those who would be reached through this man's conversion. So when God prompts you to encourage someone or invite someone or do something for him, follow that prompting. You might never know the extent of how God used you. When you do the will of God and reach out to make a difference in someone's life, God is always honored. In Matthew 5:13, Jesus said, "You are the salt of the earth." You're on this earth to add flavor, to impart a preserving quality, to make a difference. So let God make a difference through you. It might save someone's life, here and for eternity. I'm John Bradshaw for It Is Written. Let's live today by every word.